So you're going to press with God into our purpose. We're going to press with God into our future. We're going to press with God through the issues, through the warfare, or through the issues that you're going through. We're going to press with God. So that's what pressing with God means, is to look in His Word, to pray, to get revelations, to get encouragement. And also, scripture is a weapon, right? And also songs, Christian songs. So that is what press means. God put on my heart this week to have a time to come together to learn about scripture. And also not just to learn about scripture, but to be able to be encouraged, okay? So pressing with God is praying, getting revelation, getting encouragement, okay? Scripture and songs, all right? So I'm just a host of it, and it's going to be every Saturday. And this, we're starting off with the book of Proverbs. So God wants me to start off with the book of Proverbs. As we press with Him, He's going to download so much revelation and wisdom to us about what Proverbs is all about, because there's a little wisdom in Proverbs. And we know that King Solomon, he is the author of the book of the Proverbs, right? So he's the most wisest king to ever be in the Word of God. So we are here to feed on some word, because, you know, some wisdom does not, wisdom never, it's never timeless. It's great to get wisdom. And I love the book of Psalms and the book of Proverbs. But God really put on my heart to do the book of Proverbs. And I believe that we are in a season in our lives, and even in this current, you know, generation that we are in, that really digging into the books of the Bible is so important, and it's so needed, you know? So welcome to Press With God with me, by Bernice. So Press With God by Bernice, okay? So let's take a moment of prayer, and then we are going to get some encouragement from the Lord. He gave me some scriptures to share with you all, to encourage you and to edify you. And then we're going to go into Proverbs 1, okay? So Lord, I just thank you for your presence, God. I thank you for being a great, great God. I thank you, God, for just your love on your people today. I thank you for this revelation of time that we're going to spend with you. I pray that, Lord, you decrease everything that is not like me and everything that is not like you, God. You decrease it and you increase yourself. Holy Spirit, you take over at this time. I ask you for your presence to be eminent in your people and to be eminent in this place. God, I pray that, Lord, everything that is on my sister's and my brother's heart, God, I know that, Lord, you know everything. You are the God who knows everything. When we pray to you, God, you know what we are going to pray for even before we do. So Father, I pray that, Lord, you intervene on their behalf, whatever it is in their heart, God. I pray that, Lord, they will know that you are Jehovah Rapha, you are Jehovah Nissi, you are Jehovah Tiskanu, you are Jehovah Elohim. There is nothing that is impossible for you to do. So God, I pray that, Lord, I stand in the gap with them, and I believe with them, and I pray that, Lord, their faith will magnify when they pray to you. Their faith will magnify as we study Proverbs today, God. Their faith will magnify the more they look to you, God, and not to their circumstances. So Father, I pray that, Lord, you take over our heart, God. Anything that is in our heart that is not like you, God, I pray that, Lord, you remove it and you cast it out of our heart. Every thorn, every hardened thing that is in our hearts, God, I pray that, Lord, you remove it, because it's hard for us to get revelation and also to allow your word to come into our heart if our heart is blocked off, if our heart has thorns of unforgiveness, or thorns of jealousy, or thorns of gossip, or thorns of any kind, any sinful thing that is not like you. So God, I pray that, Lord, you remove anything that is not like you out of our heart, so we can have a pure heart before you, so your word can come and live in our heart, so that we will not sin against you. So God, I pray for your presence to be known here, and your kingdom to come. So I plead the blood of Jesus, God, over this time of press with you. We are pressing with you in this time, God. So take over, Father. This is your time. We are just here as your daughters and your sons to just sit at your feet and hear what you have to say. So decrease me, God, and increase yourself. Let your kingdom come. Let your will be done, God, as it is in heaven. We bind anything that needs to be bound on earth. Let it be so in heaven. And we loose everything that needs to be loose in heaven. Let it be so on earth, God. So we welcome you here, Holy Spirit, and we plead the blood of Jesus over this time. And it's in the name of Jesus I do pray. Amen. Amen, guys. So we prayed, and I'm going to read these encouraging words that God gave me today to share with everybody. So I want to talk to those that are going through some issues. Maybe you're going through some loss. You know, coronavirus happened, and a lot of people lost things. You know, maybe you lost jobs. Maybe you lost a loved one. Maybe you lost, you know, your house, or you lost something that's really precious to you. But I want to encourage you today to let you know that